Okay, welcome back to Good Day GA. Thank you for staying tuned in, where we give godly advice glorifying Jesus Christ.
Yes.
We are your hosts, Thomas and Jennifer Stearns. And if you're just tuning in, we've been discussing our journey to oneness.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So, dear, what are we on now? We were talking about our past, mm-hmm. who we were before we got together. I was a Jehovah's Witness.
Yes.
You were a carnal Christian. And why don't you break down what that means? Because maybe some people don't know what carnal means.
Mm-hmm. Well, meaning that, you know, I really did things my way, really.
Mm-hmm.
A carnal means that, you know, it's that fleshy, or that I followed everything that I wanted to do,
your
or how
flesh.
I wanted to do
mm-hmm.
it. And I tagged myself as a Christian, but I really wasn't living a true Christian way of life.
Right. Because when you give your life to Christ, that's literally what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
You're giving your life to Him, and you're now saying, you're my Lord, mm-hmm. and you can tell me what to do.
And how to do it.
And
when
how to do it, when to do it.
Where to do it.
Where to do it.
Exactly. Yeah.
But if you're a carnal Christian, you're just calling yourself a Christian. You might know some Bible verses, but you're doing what you want to do.
Almost, definitely. You know, and that's the lifestyle I lived.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I went to church all the time. I prayed.
Mm-hmm.
I fornicated.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I lied every now and then.
Okay.
You know, I mixed it up. You know, I'm playing on the devil's side and God's side.
Wow. So
you know,
you're
going
straddling
back and
the
forth.
Fence, huh?
Yeah.
That,
I mean, that's what carnal Christians do.
That's right.
You know. So you know, let's call it what it really is.
Exactly.
You know. And you know, so that's the lifestyle I had at that time.
Mm-hmm.
So now that I am a true believer of Christ, I am a disciple of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
I am an ambassador of Christ.
That's
I
right.
try to walk on one side of the road only.
That's
you know,
right.
I try to do everything that I've learned how to do in the Bible. Now, do I always do right all the time, 100% of the time?
Mm-hmm.
No,
mm-hmm.
I mess up.
Mm-hmm.
And people, you know, should know that, you know, Christians do mess up.
That's right.
But we don't stay in that place of messing up. You know,
that's right.
We don't practice that sin.
That's right.
You know, we get ourselves together
mm-hmm.
and we repent, meaning that, you know, all right, now that I know that I was doing wrong, I turn from that.
That's right.
And I go the opposite way.
Yes. That's the right way.
Yeah.
That's
so
good.
So that's what. But you know what? The funny thing about it is that, you know, how we met was online.
Online.
You know, so,
and everybody who meets us now, they can swear we met in church.
Yeah, but isn't it funny how God takes us full circle?
Full circle.
And
Look, now
here
we're
we
back
are
online.
Back online, meeting folks online.
I like
you know?
That. Yeah,
and God uses online services for
that's
us.
Right.
You know,
mm-hmm.
in our lives. And,
yeah.
you know, out of the thousands and thousands of people that were online
mm-hmm.
on this website, you know, He hooked me and you up.
That's right. God uses technology now.
Yeah. So,
yes,
I mean,
does.
I think it's fantastic. It's just mind-blowing.
Yeah, because I was only on that dating service for 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And you were the second person I talked to.
Yep.
And you were the first person who I met,
mm-hmm.
you know, face-to-face. And I only talked to that other person for a brief minute, so I knew he wasn't about nothing.
Yeah.
And then you flirted with me. I was like, okay, now. Looking pretty good over there.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, so then we connected. But, you know, at that time, I knew that I didn't want to be out in the club.
Oh, no.
You know, I knew I didn't want to meet guys the way I had met them before.
Mm.
And I thought this was the perfect opportunity to be able to leaf through a whole bunch of folks
yep.
and see the kind of qualities that I wanted.
Mm.
And I was smart enough not to put Jehovah's Witness on my profile.
Thank you, Lord, because I sure enough would have skipped right
put
over
Christian.
You.
Because they call themselves Christian.
Exactly.
You know, so I just went with the other name.
Yeah.
And,
smart.
And I was able to meet you. You know, our first date was awesome.
Mm-hmm.
You was a little fresh on that first date, though.
Well, I had to do something
mm-hmm.
that would be different.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you don't just can't be, you know, I didn't want to just bring the roses. You know,
mm-hmm.
I didn't want to bring the, you know, the stuff normal
the standard.
People do.
Mm-hmm.
I said, you know what? I'm going to make this memorable.
Yeah.
I'm
going to
make
did.
This something that we talk about all the time
mm-hmm.
because I knew that one day we would have a platform to
okay.
be able to do that.
All right, prophet.
That's right.
Not right now.
So what I did was, when I first met her, and I came to pick her up, and she was standing there outside waiting for me because she couldn't even wait.
I was too excited. I came out to meet you in the parking lot. Yes, I did.
So when I got there, I said, hello. I'm here to collect. Because we were talking on the phone about how, you know, just being silly. Mm-hmm. And how she's gonna owe me a kiss. So I came to collect my kiss. First thing I seen her.
I couldn't even get hello out my mouth before he planted a juicy one right on my mouth. I was like, what?
But you still remember it to
this
day, don't you?
Yes, I do.
That's right.
You just be glad you didn't get a right hook. You better be glad you was cute.
On that note,
But fellas, be careful with that, because that could backfire.
Yeah.
So,
you got
to
plan it right.
We're not advising you to do that.
You got to plan it right, brother. You got to plan it. Because, I already knew she was digging me. So,
yeah.
You know.
as my daughter was saying, I was a little thirsty. A little bit.
So I had to bring a glass of water. Tall glass of water.
Okay.
All right. Anyways, I digress. But so, you know, where did the hour go, honey?
Man, it went so fast.
I mean, I thought we just getting warmed up.
I know, but it's okay, because that means that our people got to come back so they can hear the rest of our story. I think we're going to be covering our courtship and how different that was than any other courtship I had ever had, any other relationship I ever had. Mm. So we're going to talk about that.
Yes.
So we just invite you, you know, join us next week for our continued discussion on our journey to oneness. And, you know, we just want to thank everyone for tuning in for our first episode. This was so exciting, and we're just looking forward to the next one. But we want to remind you to connect with us by going to wdrbmedia.com, click on Radio Show tab, and go to the Good Day GA page. Okay, continue to sign in every Saturday at 9 a.m. so you can catch Thomas and I on Good Day GA, offering godly advice, glorifying Jesus Christ.
Yes.